morning brain sharp and have some fun with music. Stir crazy, let's have some fun. Stir crazy, we're number one.
Hi, let's talk about writing. Most of you write. You write letters, or you write words, or you write sentences. You might write essays. You might write stories. You might write research papers. You write. Who should write? Would you say everybody? Everybody should write. So we agree. I agree. Everyone should write. Well, if everybody should write words and sentences and paragraphs and stories and all that, why shouldn't everybody write music? So at the same time as I'm encouraging you to write your stories, to keep journaling and writing and getting those stories of your life and other things you're interested in on paper, I'm encouraging you to learn to get your music on paper too. We've talked a little bit about that in episodes before. If you haven't, if you didn't see them, you can go back to them, or you can figure this out yourself. Remember when I told you you're your own teacher? You are responsible for your own education. That doesn't mean you don't have to do what your parents say or your teachers say, but you're responsible for you. You need to go out and discover what you're interested in, and then you need to make decisions on what you need to learn, and then you have to have a plan or a strategy how to do it. So I'm telling you, if you think everybody should write, and if you think, and as I do, now that everybody should write music, then you've got some time to figure this out, and I'd like you to do that. And let me give you some things that will help you get started. One is that writing this music has to start in the creative part of the brain. So, like you might have heard me or somebody else say before, you want to just let those ideas flow. So maybe you say, well, you have to think about it. I'd like to write a song about my cat because my cat entertains me and plays with me and sleeps with me. And sometimes I feel like my cat is my best friend. Well, there's a good line for a song. So then you just start, you just let it go. You start singing about your cat. My cat's tabby and white. My cat plays outside. My cat runs after the mice and chases them out of my room. I'm so glad for my cat. And you just go on, you know, isn't that crazy? But I'm practicing. I just made that up right now. I'm practicing how you can start to sing and make up music. Now, at a certain point, you want to start writing those things down. So just like you have letters and words and learn to make them into sentences, you have to take those musical notes from the musical alphabet, A, B, C, D, G, and learn to put them down. Now, remember that staff? We've talked about it before, or if you don't know, here it is. 5 lines, 4 spaces. Here's one of my students one time. He wrote this song. Well, now, I wrote it down for him because he sang it, and then I wrote it down. That's another thing you could do. But it has notes. It has half notes, quarter notes, whole notes. We can count it. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. See where these notes, Some of them have their rooms in the on the lines. Some of them have their rooms the outside, like this middle C. Some of you know. Yeah. All right. So this, learning this, how you write music, in the same way that you learned one time how to write your letters and how to write your words and how to make your sentences and how to write a paragraph and how to build a story. You can build songs. Just start simple. Start on one note and write a simple song, and think about what you want your song to be about. Now look, if you play the piano, you can play chords or melodies on the piano. You can just mess around and see what you can find that you might like to play. These are very general steps. And they're only meant to encourage you, as I said previously, to be responsible for your own music education. Yes, you can start. You can start now without a teacher, only with the resources you have, like a songbook or what you can find online or the people around you that know music, to develop a way to write songs. And I'll say it one more time because it's really important. Start with one note. I like frogs. It's a song. And then maybe you want to add another note. I like popcorn too. Hey, don't eat the popcorn after you played with the frogs. So anyway, what should you write? You, if you're writing in school, if you're doing your writing that you do every single day, I know you do, you write in a journal. If you're in kindergarten, first, second, third, fourth grade, you're writing in your journal. I've seen many of you do it. You are writing maybe sentences, jokes, poems. A lot of you like to write about what you did in the day. A lot of you like to write about things that are important to you, different people in your life, some plans that you have. Okay, it's that simple. This is what you would write songs about. Now, I want you to remember, you can make up those songs in your head. You can sing them because, remember what we said? Everybody can sing. If you can talk, you can sing. Just be bold. Start singing. If you want a real big dose of how to become a songwriter, do this. Say, today, oh, this will drive your parents crazy. Today, I'm going to sing everything and not say anything. So everything you want to say, sing it. By the end of the day, your vocabulary for finding musical motifs or ideas will be big and broad, and you'll be comfortable with it. So just a bunch of ideas of where is a good place to start. Now, why? Why should you do this? Why should you be a songwriter? Well, why should you be a writer? Why should you share your stories? Because you can teach something, because you can tell something, important information, or because you can evoke. There's another vocabulary word for you. You can pull feelings out of other people. You know, music is a wonderful gift that as you develop as a musician, you can share with people in your life or even the whole world. So I want you to understand what a beautiful, rare gift is inside each of you that you really need to uncover. The gift of music, it's in you. You just have to pull it out and polish a little bit. And what I'm suggesting you do is sing. Sing the thoughts in your head instead of saying them. That's like an opera, isn't it? Yep. In the opera, they sing everything instead of saying it. So let me give a story. I'm going to give you a story. We talked about gifts. This is a story that relates a little bit, but not exactly, to what we're going through now, because what we're going through now, even as old as I am, look at me, I've never gone through anything like this pandemic. But you know, I did go through some tornadoes, and a high school student who lost his entire home, but was okay, in a tornado, once wrote, I'm talking stories now, not songs, but he wrote a story. The story he brought back to his high school just because he wanted to do something. And he shared it with his friends. Well, his friends liked it because it helped him feel better. And it made the high school student feel better too then. Well, the friends shared it with their parents and it helped them feel better. And then the newspaper found out about it, so they printed it in the newspaper. And so then the whole community felt better. You have the power to do this. You have the power of word, and you have the power of song. So I'm encouraging you to write your words down, and as you can, write your songs down. Sing your songs, record them, and share them with your community now, because we need you.
Here's William, ready for another joke break. What rock band has four people that don't sing? Mount Rushmore.
Hi, it's Mike. Again, happy to see you. And today, we're going to talk about something called rest. You know, like you take a rest, you know, you lay your head down, maybe you take a nap, you know, or you stop for a little while, you're doing something, you take a break. That's a rest. Well, we have rest in music, too. And rest, let me just explain a little something. I don't want to get too complicated, you know, but we'll just talk about it real easy, okay? There's these things called note values, okay? You know, these, let's say, are quarter notes. You know, you guys have all seen a concert, you know, where the drummer counts the song off. He goes, 1, 2, 3, 4, and then the band starts playing. Well, when he says that 1, 2, 3, 4, those are quarter notes, okay? So he says 1, 2, 3, 4, okay? Now, if I took breaks in between here, we'd make a different rhythm, okay? So, rest. 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 So those are rests, okay? So that's at the rate of a quarter note. And if you guys might remember a few episodes back, we did the up by twos where we went. Right? So those are all note values, which I don't want to get too much into because it gets too complicated. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to just play my drum for you guys, and I'm going to play a steady beat. Okay, I'll play something real steady, then I'll add rest to it, and we can see the effect that has. Okay, so let's see what we can come up with here. Thank you. rest. Okay? That's the idea of rest. We could do that with our other instruments as well. Okay? Let's try a shaker. Sounds with a shaker, okay? So that's the idea of rest, okay? So when you're playing your instruments, playing all the various things we've been playing with all these times, play nice and steady, take a little break, play nice and steady, take a little break, okay? Let's see what we can come up with these boxes, okay? There's the idea of rest. So have some fun with rest. Just play, stop, and those are rests. So thanks very much. We'll see you next time, okay?
Did you know that the bassoon is one of the most difficult instruments in the orchestra to play? Some people call it the clown of the orchestra because it looks so silly. It's a woodwind instrument, so it means that it is made out of wood and is played by using the wind of your breath. Can you make wind with your breath? Another interesting thing about the bassoon is that it is the only instrument in the orchestra that you play using all 10 of your fingers. Here's Mason with a little bassoon sample. How cool is that?
Hi, this is Anna, and I am going to tell you about another artist I like. This one is named Romero Brito. So Romero Brito was born in Brazil, but he lives in Miami, and he is still alive making art. This is one of his art pieces. He does really, really bright, colorful art pieces with lots of pattern. So you can see he uses polka dots, stripes, solid colors. He uses little hash marks. It's maybe kind of hard to see, but like these little squiggles are actually his signature, where he repeats his signature over and over again. And a lot of times he does cats and dogs and other images where you can see the lines kind of cut the picture into a lot of different pieces where you might not normally expect to see those lines dividing it. Teddy bear. Romero Brito does his art as printed images and also as sculptures. Sometimes they're really intricate, like this, where we see people's faces and a whole scene happening. Other times they're a little bit more simple, like that flower or like the cat or the dog. So together we are going to make some Romero Brito inspired art. That's my challenge to you. So the first thing that I want you to do is to take a piece of your printer paper, and we are going to fold it in half the hot dog way, and then we're going to fold it into thirds, like you're mailing a letter, so that we end up with 6 different sections. Then in each of these sections, I want you to put a little number, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and at least fill each section with a different pattern. So at least 6 different patterns. If you can come up with more patterns than that, that's great. You can use some extra ones. So here is one that I did using only circles. So I did some closed dots of different sizes. I did some open dots of different sizes. I did some little dots in a pattern. I did what we call concentric circles, where they're stacked going out like a bullseye. I did a pattern of circles overlapping each other, and I did a pattern of little sets of concentric circles. So this, I came up with 6 patterns using only circles and dots. I did these with different types of lines. So I have some diagonal lines, some zigzag lines, some wavy lines, some curly lines, some fat and thin stripes, and some dotted lines. So here's another 6 ideas just with lines. You come up with your own 6, okay? And then if you have a die at home from playing Monopoly or Yahtzee, looks like this, you can use that to help you determine which of your patterns you're going to use. If you don't have one of those at home, you can just pick as you go. All right, then we're gonna make our art piece. Oh, we're also gonna need a piece of paper and a ruler and some markers or crayons or other things that you want to decorate it. So we're gonna start by making a heart, okay? A nice big heart that fills up your page. Then we're gonna take our ruler and we are gonna draw some lines that crisscross through our heart. We're gonna divide this picture up into different sections, just like Romero Brito's art. And then we're gonna decorate each of those sections. I think I need another one right here. We're gonna decorate each of those sections with a different pattern. So if you need help deciding which pattern, that's where you can use a die to roll that and help you decide which one you're going to do. Otherwise, you can just pick them as you go. So I'm gonna take this section and make some stripes. I'm gonna take this section and make my polka dots. That marker doesn't want to show up very well. Maybe this section here, I'll do my concentric circles. Okay? You get to decide what patterns you do and what colors you do and how you want to create your own Romero Brito inspired art piece. All right, have a good time. Happy creating. We'll be right back.
everyone. I'm Megan from the Red Wing Public Library, and today I have with me my friend Gaston, who stars in his own book, Gaston, to help me sing a song about the arrival of a very special pet. So, if you know the song, There's a Spider on the Floor by Raffi, you will probably be able to figure this one out. But there are no spiders in this song because it is not spider season. It is puppy season. So this is There's a Puppy at the Door. There's a puppy at the door, at the door. There's a puppy at the door, at the door. Who could ask for any more than a puppy at the door? There's a puppy at the door, at the door. Now, there's a puppy in the house, in the house. There's a puppy in the house, in the house. Oh, could it be a mouse? No, it's a puppy in the house. There's a puppy in the house, in the house. Now, there's a puppy on the stair, on the stair. There's a puppy on the stair, on the stair. Oh, does anybody care? There's a puppy on the stair. There's a puppy on the stair, on the stair. Now, there's a puppy in the hall, in the hall. There's a puppy in the hall, in the hall. Oh, that puppy's got a ball. That puppy in the hall. There's a puppy in the hall, in the hall. Now, there's a puppy in the tub, in the tub. There's a puppy in the tub, in the tub. Oh, give him a scrub-a-dub. That puppy in the tub. There's a puppy in the tub, in the tub. Now, there's a in my room, in my room. There's a puppy in my room, in my room. There's a puppy in my room. Oh, watch him play and zoom, zoom. There's a puppy in my room, in my room. Now, there's a puppy on my bed, on my bed. There's a puppy on my bed, on my bed. He's sleeping by my head. That puppy on my bed. There's a puppy on my bed, on my bed. All right. Thank you all so much for listening today. And don't forget to check out Gaston and his adventures in his book. You can get that book as an ebook from the Red Wing Public Library. I hope you're all having a great day, and we'll see you next time.
Hey, everybody, we hope you like Stir Crazy. Don't forget to tune in again next week for a new episode. One, two, sing along. Stir Crazy, let's have some fun.